Hello, 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 everybody. How are you doing tonight? I know what you're thinking. Now, Rye, didn't you say the stream was going to be at 2 o'clock? And then didn't you say the stream was going to be at 4 o'clock? And now it's 8 o'clock. What happened? And, well, to be truthful, life happened. I mean, quite honestly. We had some car trouble that needed to get addressed. We had some other things that needed to get fixed. And things needed to be taken care of around the house. There was just no way I was going to make the stream time because I had other responsibilities I had to do. And I tried to keep people notified of things, but, you know, there's only so much you can do, right? But I insisted, and I am here to stream. So I am here. And just as along with everything else that's kind of gotten complicated, plans for the stream got changed too. Originally, it was going to be Gaming Way was going to take over today, and we were going to play some RPG Maker games from my library. But I got this idea. I found out that this mod for Skyrim got updated for the anniversary edition with all the collector's creation club content and everything like that. And, you know, I was going to start doing kind of a Skyrim thing anyway because of... we're kind of taking a break and waiting for the VODs to catch up on YouTube. So I decided that, hey, why don't I just have some fun and start doing the Skyrim thing tonight? And because it sounded really fun. And, you know, honestly, and the RPG Maker games will always be there and always be a very weird little corner of my library. But I felt like doing this tonight, so that's what I'm doing. Other than that, it's been kind of just a wacky day. But I think first and foremost, we need to get some notes out here because we actually got a new follower. Pokawings! Thank you for joining the party! Great to have you around with a name like Pokawings. I'm gonna have to say Dragoon. Someone who could take to the sky. That or a machinist, because airships, I guess? Anyway. But no, it was just overall, just kind of like, I put this big post on my blog, and I don't know if you guys have ever stopped by and check out the blog, but it's Frykerion.com. I do written content on there, it's not just to host my videos and everything like that, but I put out this post that was 15 years, I have been running that blog, in one form or another, for 15 years at this point. Well, technically 15 years in September. And I decided to just do some kind of soul searching and talking about, like, all the different places that has taken me. And how that's been, you know, chasing fame through multiple different mediums. Exploring things that I enjoyed, things that I didn't enjoy, my regrets, my successes, things that I loved, and just kind of where do I want to go with this now? Because, I mean, let's face it, 15 years in, and no one knows your name, you're really just doing it for the love at that point. Because, as I like to say, I like anonymous, popular content. A lot of my content on my website is very popular, and a lot of different people consume it. It gets referred to by Reddit quite a bit. I know at least on both the Star Wars The Old Republic and Final Fantasy XIV subreddits, they drop links to my stuff quite regularly. But at the same time, I don't think anyone knows that I wrote it. Like... they don't really know that there's a who the person behind it is. It's just easygoing content. You know, this is a good summary of, like, all the expansions, read it to get caught up, alright, moving on type of thing. Which is fine. You know, at least it's something that people are finding useful. That was always kind of the point, was to do something that people would find useful. I just wish that there was a little bit of name recognition attached to it. Like, oh yeah, have you seen Vicarian's site? He has a good write-up on that sort of... I don't really get that much, really, that I know of. But, you know. You do what you do. Same thing with on here. You know? I stream because I'd be doing this anyway. I mean, I'd playing video games and making snarky commentary and whatnot. That's my normal way of playing games. You can ask my wife. She listens to me all the time. I'm always cracking wise at video games when we're playing through them and stuff like that. And we have a blast doing it. So I just thought, hey, why don't film myself? And I ended up choosing going with a VTuber route because, well, that way I don't have to show my face. Because I know I ain't a looker. But, you know, if you got some time, check out the blog, check out the post. I like to think that there's enough insight for people online to kind of understand that, like, don't follow my bad examples, do follow my good examples. Because I've done both. I've made mistakes with how invested and how I've decided to do content. And I've had good mentalities about how to do things. And it's really... I try and warn people about both and steer people the right way in that post. And I don't know. I think people get a kick out of it. I just noticed that my follower counter here is way off. According to Twitch, I have 39. And this says I have 45. Well, how did that happen? I have no idea. That just jumped up today, too. I have no idea how that happened. That was not that high last time I looked at it. I suppose I'm looking the wrong way. It's over there, isn't it? Hi, counter. Anyway. But I wanted to just say a shout out to everybody who's, you know, coming in and hanging out and just enjoying the streams. I think one of the big things I came to at the conclusion of that writing that post was just, you know, I'm just gonna just do this kind of stuff for me, you know? I'm not gonna, like, strive for being the you know, I'm just gonna have fun. I'm just gonna play games I wanna play. Throw out all sorts of different things. And just have fun with it. Because, I mean, normally I'm my own snarky self. And really, that's what I gotta stay true to. And that's kind of the conclusion I came to. And because of that, you know, here we are now. I changed up what I was doing today. I wasn't gonna do RPG game thing, blah, blah, blah. I wanted to play this new Skyrim setup. I got this new Skyrim setup. I will say, a disclaimer up front. This is definitely a modded version of Skyrim, but on that note, there are not much in the way of graphical mods here. This isn't going to be the pretty Skyrim experience. Most of the mods I'm running here are balancing and content. So Legacy of the Dragonborn being the big one, pretty much everything I've put into this entire build mod list is all things designed to work with that Legacy of the Dragonborn, which, if you're not familiar with it, essentially, the basic premise is a museum has opened up in Solitude dedicated to the legend of the Dragonborn and all your various escapades and whatnot and all the different things across Skyrim. And you get hired on, coincidentally being the Dragonborn, to help populate this museum. Essentially, it's a big collectathon. A lot of collecting things, like, get this, get one of every outfit, get, you know, this rare thing that was here, get this strange thing, put these on display. You get to build out a museum, you get to decorate it and fill it up with stuff, and it turns from this empty hall into, like, a full-on museum, and it's awesome. But they just updated it for the first time in a while that added back in all of this, the Anniversary Edition content. And so I'm really excited to get it tried out. And since you have to do a brand new game when they do major updates, because it just there's no way to retroactively put some of this stuff in properly, I decided to just do one with you guys and kind of get things started up here. So I think with that said, I think we're just going to hop right into the game here. There we go. Now, we've already skipped ahead a little bit into the character creation portion. You might notice the fact that this is not your standard background for creating a character in Skyrim. That is because we're using a mod called Alternate Start, Alternate Life. The big thing there is it essentially gets you a multiple different things, and this is mostly because the regular vanilla, oh, you're awake finally, blah blah blah, opening that everyone's used to, I 9 times out of 10 when I do mods, it just completely breaks the opening. So I use this and I just start somewhere else and just skip that whole thing so it doesn't break. Like, I tried to test this out just to see if it would break before stream, and okay, you'll love this. New one for me, everyone was just standing by the carts. Not on them, but next to them. All lined up, including all of the Imperials, the Stormcloaks, the Horse Thief, everybody. They're just waiting in line. And then the guy who starts talking, the guy who's like, you woke up, you just woke up. He just starts rattling off all his lines. Like, one after another after another. No pause in between. No, no other dialogue interjected in between. So the entire thing with the horse thief, like, where are you from? And all that stuff. Yeah, no, that does not come up at all. it's kind of a crazy thing. So we're starting out with this. I wanted to do a character I've never done before. I almost always play Imperials or Nords or something like that. Breton, maybe. But, you know, I wanted the idea of, like, the museum and everything like that. And I really, really wanted to do a kind of a orc librarian kind of character. I just thought it would be fun. Wait, now we need to finish making him. Let's see here. I like the facial paint on that one and the eyes. I don't like the beard, but we can tweak the beard. I just like the idea of these, like, this big, like, brutish looking, like, stereotypical orc type guy, but then he's actually just, you know, he's a scholar. Well, he says, like, where's the only thing I really wanted to change on him was his hair. Yes, facial hair. You just go clean shaven, I guess. Mm. Black hair. Can you turn your head, please? Thank you. Ponytail, huh? Don't know if I'm gonna go for that. It was weird. I didn't realize that there were so many exclusive options, kind of, to the orc. I like that ponytail, kind of. Let's see, do they have a wolf knot? Wolf tail? That looks actually kind of scholarly. I actually kind of dig that. And you shall be known as Norm Al-Human. Ooh, the FPS is not looking great on the stream, but as you can see now, it's going to start loading up all the different mods we have and everything like that. But yeah, this is the alternate start. Essentially, you just start in this little prison cell. You can't actually do anything. No one responds.
Approach, my child, and choose where your new life shall begin.
And you get all these different options. There's vanilla start. And there is one I could have downloaded that is specifically for the Legacy of the Dragonborn Museum. But the problem with that one is that it also skips a bunch of the quests because it pre-establishes something that happens later in the storyline for the guild or for the museum.
Which city did you sail to?
So because of that, I kind of decided to skip that one, and we're going to start with a sailing to Solitude because that starts
Solitude
you
with opportunity awaits you, traveler.
in the right town to kind of get things started with. So we could just go straight to the museum. We don't have to worry about like trying to get all the way there, go deal with all this other stuff. And because of that, it's an excellent opportunity. So yeah, have you traveled here as a relic hunter for the museum in the Solitude? Yeah. And it starts you out with a quest. No, we're not doing survival mode because oh yes, there's a religion mod now too. Religion. Most ta denizens of Tamriel are religious. You may choose to follow a deity, receiving a minor blessing and learning about their sacred tenets. If you wish to follow a different deity later, find and activate their shrine in the world. Well, I only get two as an orc. That's interesting. I can either go with Malakath or Trinimac, which is interesting because I think it's actually the lore. They're actually just different facets of the same god? Led armies of the original elven tribes against mankind. Improved attacks against humans. Slay humans. Defeat epic foes. Never accept Boethia's blessing or serve her. Those skilled and two-handed are more deserving of my favor. Okay, what does Malakath give me? Improved power attacks. Defeat epic foes, improve weapon and armor, never commit a crime against strongholds, and skilled in smithing. Well, this one has the least amount of drawbacks. Yeah, I'll take Malakath then.
You talk to Ed Brothers. DJ has no words for you.
Just wanted to go down there and get that fast travel point. Where are ooh. Oh, here we go. Greetings, my friend. I hope this letter finds you well, finds you well. It's been some time since we've worked together, and I have a proposition for you, assuming you can be persuaded to pull yourself from your work at the Gwilyn University. See, it knows I'm a scholar. I recall in your last letter you expressed wishing to get back on the field again. I think this proposal will have you intrigued. I have been fortunate enough to have been able to establish a museum here in Skyrim in the City of Solitude, for which I have named for the prophetic legends of the Dragonborn, dubbing it Dragonborn Gallery. I have, however, not had much luck in procuring adequate relics for the museum, I brought with me a few alien items of my own collection, but there's a vast array here in Skyrim, as research suggests. There also seems to be a gathering of sorts, with notable artifacts rumored to have been found their way here. But I can tell you more about that later. I would be honored if you'd be willing to assist me by becoming the museum's relic hunter. I know with your skilled assistance, you can make this museum 10 times more grand than the Mournhold Museum ever was. I can offer you free room and board as well, as the museum is a very well-equipped safe house above it, just gathering dust. I prefer to sleep in the staff barracks where I can be close to my work. I have enclosed 500 gold for incentive and travel expenses. I look forward to seeing you here, my friend. Assuming your interest is aroused, when you arrive in Solitude, just head to the Blue Palace at the far southeastern end of the city. The museum is the massive building just beside the palace. Aurin Morales, Museum Curator, Dragonbone Gallery. So that is going to be our new boss. So, oh yeah, we start out with a nice little outfit here. And a sword. Yeah. Let's see here. So we actually have quite a bit of... some rings. A ring of minor conjuration. That's nice. Explorer's Guide to Skyrim. Helgen Reborn Guide. The Key to the Dragonborn Gallery. And sure enough, we got like over 1,000 gold to start with. That ain't bad. Definitely better than starting out as a prisoner, eh? Okay, that's the stable.
Good business.
Hello.
For the East Empire Company means all the more gold for the Empire.
Well, that's good, I think. Do we want the Empire to have gold? I mean, I really don't have a side in the whole thing, because, well, for one, I'm an orc. Two, I'm an academic. Hello.
If you've come to Solitude to join the Legion, speak to Ricca. If not, just keep your nose clean while you're here, or you'll end up like Rogvir.
Who's Largvir?
Time to say hello to Rogvir. He's the sorry bastard who's going to be executed.
Why are you executing him?
Ulfric Stormcloak escaped the city after he killed the High King.
Who's Ulfric Stormcloak? You have to admit, it's not exactly the best impression here. Oh, hi, how are you doing? You're just here in time to see the execution. And execution!
Position.
Pardon me, sir, can I have your axe, please?
You betrayed us.
Huh? People are talking. I don't know.
Escaped the city after he murdered High King Torrig. By opening that gate for Ulfric, you betrayed the people of Solitude.
Yeah?
He doesn't deserve to speak!
There was no murder.
Liar!
He beat the High King in fair combat. Such is our way. Such is the ancient custom of Skyrim and all Nords.
This is our ancient tradition. Boo! Tradition bad.
On this day, I go to Sovngarde.
Can I? I don't suppose. Are you just gonna stand there? Why is everyone looking at me? He's already dead, lady! Actually, who said that? was Jala, but there is no Jala here.
There's nothing like a good song to lift the spirit in troubled times.
Man, I forgot what you looked like without all the other mods. Hi. Can I? Thank you. I was really worried he was gonna stab me! I didn't want to get stabbed.
You look like you could do with a ripe apple, or a tomato, cabbage, or leek.
And you? Hey. What's the sound the ocean makes?
An apple to keep you healthy.
Oh.
A tomato to keep you strong. But surely you need one or the other.
You get some interesting people here.
I had a messenger from Dragon Bridge stop here on his way to the Blue Palace not too long.
You don't say. A messenger.
Mentioned something about needing help. I have my ways, but it's not easy these days.
Oh yeah?
Black blood marauders have been plundering ships off the coast. A lot of people been hurt by their foolishness.
Right, but their foolishness seems to be very profitable for them. What? We were just having a lovely chat. What about the messenger? Can you tell me about the messenger? No, apparently not. Nightshade. Ooh, flower, nightshade.
Need something?
Darn kids. Oh! Stand corrected, creepy kid. Hi.
Huh? Oh, sorry.
Why are you staring at the graves, kid?
Oh, okay, I guess. It's hard with father gone. I really miss him.
I can go get him for you.
If I were older, then I'd join up with the Legion and get my revenge on those Stormcloak rebels who killed father. But mother says I can't join until I'm 17.
Have you tried lying?
She needs something. We're paying our respects to me dead husband. Henry and I lost his father in the war. Now, I do what I can to get by and care for Henry.
That's awful.
Thank you. We manage. I just have to keep Henry entertained and out of trouble. That's the really hard part.
Have you tried lying?
We're paying our respects to me dead husband. Henry and I lost his father in the war.
You help me. You help people, right? That's what you do.
I... Sure. What do you need?
My master has abandoned me. Abandoned his people. And nothing I say can change his mind. Now he refuses to even see me. He says I interrupt his vacation. It's been so many years. Won't you please help?
Why don't you just work somewhere else?
Without him, I am not free. Without him, I am doomed. All of his empire shall fall into chaos.
What? Okay, so without him, you're doomed. But without all of his empire falling into...
Last I saw him, he was...
That doesn't make any sense.
...in the Blue Palace. But no one as mundane as the Jarl. No. Such people are below him. No, he went into the forbidden wing of the palace to speak with an old friend. Said it had been ages since they had last had tea. Oh, and you'll need the hippo. It's very important.
Oh, of course.
No one can use his wing without that.
So you need me to bring him back?
But don't try to use force. He's far too mighty. He'd crush you like a clay doll or drop you from the sky. Or simply eat your brain right up. Oh, but he probably won't do those things to you. Probably. Just remind him to come home, and there'll be no fighting or unpleasantness. Probably.
The fact that you had to say probably 3 times is worrying.
Knowing my master, he may very well reward you for bringing him to his senses.
Oh, good.
He is a great man, but one rarely...
Yeah, who is he?
He rules twin empires that span the length and breadth of our minds. All know him, but few can name him. But He has forbidden me from saying his name. He says it distracts him, and woe to those who draw his ire. But you will know him when you see him. He's the one who made me like this.
What?
All right, then.
All right, I'll see what I can do. I guess. Let's just run up here to the palace really quick and get the fast travel point. There we go. So yeah, this is the Dragonborn Gallery. It's very pretty. Hey!
I trust things fare well.
They fare. There's a crazy guy outside. He might try to sleep on your bench. Heads up. Voyage was long but uneventful.
Well, let me give you the 10 septum tour then.
Okay.
This building was once called Magnarian Hall and was built as a temple dedicated to Talos, the patron god of the Nords. After the White Gold Concordat, however, the statue was moved and the temple closed. I came here a few years ago and was able to procure use of the space in the pursuit of establishing this museum.
Oh.
Of course, I have had the building vastly expanded over the last 2 years.
I can see that.
It will become one of the grandest collections of Tamrielic history in the world. This grand atrium I call the Hall of Heroes. It is where a variety of historically significant relics can be displayed. And it's quite a striking entrance to the museum, if I do say so myself. Off to the right is the reception hall and staff barracks, as well as the museum office where I do much of my work. To our left, you'll find the central hallway leading to all the other galleries of the museum, which also serves as the cultural arts exhibit.
Over there.
Here, I hope to display a variety of art, as well as elements representing the more primitive cultures here in Skyrim, such as the Falmer, Forsworn, the Giants, and more.
Watch yourself there, Auron.
Access to the East Exhibit Halls, which houses the Daedric Gallery, the Hall of Lost Empires, Hall of Oddities, and the Hall of Legends, which showcase a vast array of relics pertaining to the Daedra, Dwemer, Falmer, and ancient Nordic cultures, as well as a number of peculiar items that defy simple classification. At the close end of this hall, the stairwell will lead to the Hall of Wonders and Armories in the basement, and up to the second floor. There you will find access to the Natural Science Gallery, as well as the Dragonborn Hall, where I will commission a variety of displays heralding any of your accomplishments.
Why my accomplishments? I'm not the Dragonborn. Wink, wink.
On this floor, the door on the right also connects to the new...
I can't wink.
If you cannot find me in my office, you will almost certainly find me whiling away the hours in the library. Also, you should pick up a copy of the museum guide at the entrance of the museum.
Gotcha.
You know the schedule of where I'm working, should you need to find me. And it will give you an easier way of navigating the museum, as well as keep track of how many displays our museum has. Of course, it may take me a moment to update those accounts, so check the guide again if you feel the numbers seem off. I'm sure I'll eventually...
Oh yeah, I'm sure I'm gonna keep track of the numbers. I'll let you know exactly if we're like one thing off.
The prep station in my office. And I'll ensure everything you have gets properly displayed if it has an appropriate place. I'm likely to have a variety of tasks for you, but in between, I'm sure you could help me find a random relic or two I've been researching.
Okay.
Feel free to look around and come find me if you have any questions. I'm very excited about the prospects of where we are headed. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. I did promise you room and board after all, didn't I?
Yes.
Here is the key to the safe house upstairs. You can get to the safe house through the stairwell in the staff barracks. Or by going outside the museum through the door in the upper level of the atrium. The balcony out front connects to the safe house patio. And lastly, I have a few leads for you to get started as you get more familiarized with Skyrim.
Oh, good.
Also, this region can be very treacherous with all the frost trolls, saber cats, and the like. The areas to the south may prove a better place to start.
Oh.
First is an artifact I heard is for sale by a general merchant in Helgen named Borgoth. He said he would hold the item for me for a while.
Oh, good.
So it may be best to retrieve it first. The others, well, the notes will tell you all you need to know about them.
So, to give you an idea of what we're looking at here with this place, it's a whole big place where you can create not just, like, store things and whatnot, but you also can have, like, make duplicates of one-of-a-kind items. There's a bunch of places for different signs and everything like that. Like I said, this is the Hall of Heroes, so either you have a bunch of items that can go here. Here's Shield of Uthgrimmar, Uthrod, stuff like that. A Hall of Wonders. This is new! I do not think this was here the last time I actually played this game. Oh. Fishing displays. Ooh. That's cool. Oh, there's a whole nother section over here. Oh, wow. This looks like it's all just for the Creation Club stuff that came with the at Anniversary Edition. Oh, look, there's even a display for the horse armor. This is so cool. I'm so happy about this. And of course, whoa, this is huge! I was not expecting all of this stuff. Like, this all expanded. That is crazy. Yeah, this is just, I mean, to give you an idea, like, almost, there's a room like this that's just for Daedric artifacts. There's a room like this that's just for, like, Dwarven artifacts. Stuff like that, all throughout this place. There's one for, creating models of different, taxidermy models of, various animals throughout Skyrim and things like that. This is the main one where you have all the different armor sets. So you have, like, here, this is the Dragonbone, Daedric Armors, Stalrim, Forsworn, Ancient Nordic, Dwarven, Steel, Iron, that sort of thing. So. It's really kind of cool. So that's the museum itself, and I'm not going to give a full tour right now, because there's literally nothing in here right now. But there's always, like, a ton more stuff, like, up here, let's see, there's more here, including a place to hold the Elder Scrolls themselves, and then, like, there's a whole section where, if you go and find different types of brews and drinks and foods, things like that. There's a wine cellar downstairs that you can keep all of that in, including a thing to, like, mix your own. There's paintings you can find to hang up in the hallways. It's a massive, massive mod. That's kind of why you have to, like, start from scratch when you get a new version of it, because it's like so much of this is just like just huge stuff, and like if you don't have like the updates and everything like that, you'll end up missing parts of it. Like if you installed this mod after you've done already some stuff, it will end up being like you missed this drop that was only available at this one point and you can't get it again now and all that sort of stuff. And like this is in the house, you can like store meats and foods and whatnot, and they'll populate in here. So you actually like slowly build up not just like a museum, but you can also fill up your house with food and silverware, diningware, all sorts of different things. There's a workshop, which you always have to be careful about because these mannequins like to move on you. None of this stuff is actually usable, though. Like, this is all just display purposes to, like, it's a storage crate, actually, that, like, has all the ingots and everything. But you can't actually pick those up. It has, like, an auto-sorting chest, so you just throw everything in there and it'll sort everything out for you here. So, with that said, why don't we get started on our first hunt? Here's a few to-do items that will get you off on the right foot, I think. Firstly, Bolgarth of the Finest Wares Emporium is holding a small collection of rare Nordic burial urns, which he was only willing to hold for a short time. If you could make that a priority, I appreciate it. Another area of interest would be Bleak Falls Barrow, a rather sizable Merithic-era dragon temple, which could hold some very good history or relics. It's easily reachable and just west of Riverwood. Lastly, an old Nordic ruin near Whiterun called Silent Moon's Camp. There's rumor of a special forge there that creates unusual weapons. Should prove to be interesting place to investigate. But do be careful. I've heard some rumors that the bandits have made their home there and are trying to uncover a missing treasure of sorts. Good luck, my friend. So I don't know if the best way to get back there. I don't think we have fast travel to anywhere down south, right? Yeah. So if we're gonna, Helgen is our priority here. We might be best off like hitching a ride from the stable over to Falkreath. There you are. How you doing, sir?
Need a ride?
Take me places. Taxi. Falkreath.
Climb and back and we'll be off.
Gotcha.
We couldn't ask for better weather.
I don't know, it's a bit foggy for me, really. But you know what they say? Fog is really just rain's cousin. Someone says that, I'm pretty sure.
No lollygagging.
What? I just walked in! Chill out, dude! Yeah, trouble, you're giving me crap. I'm just showing up and saying hi. Yeesh. Walking! I am literally walking, sir!
They say Ulfric Stormcloak murdered the High King.
So?
His voice. shouted him apart.
So you're saying he was a Karen? Is that what I'm getting from this? Fusrod, take me to your manager! Man, it's very nice. I do. Even vanilla. I mean, granted, I think it was updated a little bit for, like, high definition for the anniversary edition, but still a very pretty game, even without the mods. Well, I mean, until you look at the people. They're less pretty. What's going up here? I mean, it's on the way. We might as well take a look. Or not! Yep, nope. I'm not gonna take on something that's 7 levels higher than me. Pass. Hey guys, help me! This is Spriggan! What? Oh, you guys suck! What did I ever do to you? I mean, if you're gonna split my belly like a woman's purse? What does that even mean? Are old women known for, like, spilling their purses? No? Usually the stereotype is that they don't like to spend money. Alright, that's something. I don't usually read all the books. There's just... We'd be here all night if I ended up reading every book I picked up. Oh! Let me get some mead. Some bow and some arrow. Well, you have an amethyst, that's nice. Fur armor. Hide boots. And if you look, there's actually a little icon on the item where it says hide boots. That means I haven't added this one to my library, my museum yet. So I always have a way of seeing, like, what do I still need to hold on to? What can I return? What can I sell? What can I get rid of? I'm sure none of you are any good. And the ones with the hand means I already have one. And if it has a green check mark, it means I've actually got it actually in the museum already. Purple mountain flowers. What's this here? Hello. Oh. I'm not gonna bother with that right now. We have a mission! We need to get to Helgen! To get those rare pots! What? Are you? Hello?
A milk drinker like you doing out here. Go home to your mother.
Yeah.
Why? What are you gonna do? Cry?
Maybe?
I don't have to take that from you. You should have come here.
I tried. I tried to help. You didn't even use the potions. Look, I'm just really tired of just... I'm just trying to walk places, and people keep giving me so much crap. I'm running an errand for the museum. That's it. I'm just ready for that deer to start giving me crap. Actually, this... I am a terrible shot. Oh, poor thing. Shot it in its butt and it charged off. I'm sorry, but I need your hide for making a museum. Very good cause, Mr. Deer. Elk. Or deer related to elk. What? Okay. Yeah, showed him. Okay. Yeah, I think the urns are kind of out of the question at this point. Body turns to ash as you touch it, but somehow a leather journal survived the attack. Somehow, leather journal has returned. Let's see. Hard to believe I filled up that whole journal already. Realize that Cyrodiil hasn't even seen it yet. Expedition is ending soon. Everyone will be returning home. I have one last task performed. I was 3 days away from retirement. I'll send the other journal ahead with my supplies and artifacts we recovered. Received contact from a Skyrim. Quiet for now, probably the first time seeing a High King Torg was killed. Probably to make for the crossing quietly. Enough during the night, so there are no Imperial patrols to deal with. So is this the guy who got caught instead of us? So much for being discreet. I crossed the border near a small village called Helgen and made my way up the Darkwater Crossing. Fortunately, I can't get back to my camp now because the area is filled with Imperial patrols. It seems they're searching for someone. Someone very important. If I'm not mistaken, someone they intend to ambush here. Could be the very thing I am seeking here in Skyrim. But crossing the border is dead night without passing through the checkpoints has turned out to be a very bad plan. I woke up this morning with the Imperial sword pressed to my neck. A patrol found me camped out near a rock outcropping on the edge of the volcanic marshes. I guess I wasn't as well hidden as I thought? I have no idea where they're taking us, but I've been stuffed in the back of a rickety old cart and pulled by an even more rickety-looking old nag. At least they let me keep my journal for now. Sure as bones, if only I'd known sooner, the ambush, the captives of the cart, Stormcloak rebels! Led by none other than Ulfric Stormcloak himself. There's no time to explain properly. I scarcely believe it myself. Hadn't been for the dragon, I'd not even be able to write this down. You're journaling while the dragon is attacking? Yes, a dragon. Big black and as large as towers of the keep itself. It swooped out of nowhere and laid waste to the village of the keep. General Tullius didn't take my head today, or the heads of several Stormcloak rivers, but that doesn't matter now. Hadvar and Railoff set aside their differences to help the survivors. They went into the lower keep hours ago. Something about caves within the back entrance? I don't think they're coming back. I I'll have to see if I can get out of the city and down to Riverwood. Someone needs to warn them. This building won't remain standing for much longer. I still can't believe it. A dragon. Straight out of the legends. Nobody back home is ever going to believe me. I just like the fact that he's journaling this while the dragon is burning down the town. I left all of my artifacts in the castle of It's literally a Monty Python joke. Don't really need to go to the Helgen Keep. Where does it want me to go now? Investigate the cave mentioned in the journal. Okay. Do you think they might have the pottery in here? Maybe they stashed it. Maybe it's not all is lost. Right? Maybe? Hello? Hello, you're dying. You're dying. I came back here for whatever's in this cart. I came to see what's going on here. I am mad! You need to warn Riverwood! Stop messing around and get down there! What? No. No, you don't understand. Told to Oblivion with it. Need a healing potion before I can go on. Once I'm back on my feet, we can go together and warn them. So long as the dragon still isn't out there. I can give you a healing potion. Or... That's magic. I don't want that. Oh, is that my only option? Is to bring Hadvar a healing potion? Or I save everyone in Riverwood as the sole survivor of a dragon attack. Oh, Yates, you got up no problem there. Oh, have you got that healing potion yet? Yeah, you're looking really banged up there, Hadvar. Yeah, you can have that. What about the other guy? Oh, rocks fell on him. He died. This is suddenly my D&D game. Yay, we got out before it collapsed.
Good this time. But I don't think we should stick around to see if he comes back.
Hey, you got your voice back.
This town from here is Riverwood. My uncle's the blacksmith there. I'm sure he'd help you out. It's probably better if we split up. Good luck. I wouldn't have made it without your help today. Closest town from... It's probably best if we split up. Good luck. I wouldn't have made it without your help today.
Yeah, of course you wouldn't. I helped you. I always like saving Hadvar because you get free stuff from the blacksmith. I don't know, let's use all of these. I know you can only keep one, but I think, yeah, see, it adds it to the museum when you... You think he's still essential? Maybe? Ruining my big story. I was supposed to be the sole survivor. I need to take this out on someone. Here. Go see what's down here.
This again. Told you, we have someone standing guard out there. Don't forget the rock trap.
Yeah.
So, stop your worrying.
Literally, no one can get past both of those things. Said it yourself. No one could have done that. Got in, right? Ooh, neat shield. Just... We rigged up two hull defense mechanisms. Maybe they could have got past the guard. But the rocks? How would they have possibly seen the tripwire? How? Impossible. Got me working down here for days. Told me Kel was time to add extra supports. Oh. Poor guy. Is there anything interesting here? I'm actually going to take some of the stuff here because, as I noted before, you can actually put this stuff in your little safe house, and it'll actually populate. What was that? guy? Was there a guy there?
Time to end this little game.
It's not a little game. It's like 15 gigs. Let's see. Boots. There's... Question. Armor. Is there any better armor for me right now? No. I am wearing, well, iron plate, but it's way heavier and for the same amount of armor. Well, that didn't work out nearly the way I wanted it to. Did you seriously just open the door for me?
Anybody there? Time to end this little.
I like how he got hit in the back of the head with a. I'm carrying too much. Oh no no. I'm not carrying too much. I'm carrying just enough. Oh fine. Okay, let's see. Fur armor we don't need to be carrying around because it is not a displayable item in the museum. Apparently neither is studded armor or the heavy painted round shield. Hide, though, is. For some reason. But I don't need two. I don't need that many hide boots. What am I carrying around all these boots for? There, just drop all that stuff. Once we get to Riverwood, we'll fast travel back and drop things off at the... Well, that's the stuff I just dropped, okay. Stone of the Forebears! Ooh, a card of spiders, too. You found a fate card. These cards are grouped into decks. 13 cards of the same type. When you possess at least one of each card of the type, you can use any of the cards to set to make a deck. And it'll provide you with special power skills. Oh, so it's like the Dark Moon cards from World of Warcraft. And they don't hear this at all. They're just... No one's sitting there going like, who's mining up there? We don't have anybody working the mines. We just have a bunch of guards. Nope, doesn't even occur to them. Elder Scrolls Plate, Morrowind. How meta. And nobody notices nothing. Stop. Good. Victory. Oh, he finally noticed something. Why are you laying down? Sorry, Orc brother. Just sometimes. Okay, what do I need here? Do I have hide armor? Constantly trying to remember exactly what I have and I don't have. That cannot be picked. It requires a key. Who has the key? Also, we are once again. Yes, I did have hide armor, and boots, and bracers. Note to self, don't need all this stuff right this second. Fishing rod? We had more time. Well, it's not a matter of time, I suppose, is it? If we had more inventory space. Potato, housekeeper. Nothing really interesting here. Chest. I'm more curious about, like, some gems. Let's see. Pretty sure there's another chest back here. There you are. Ah, this one's locked. This. Aha! See, I'm really good at picking locks because I have these big old ears. Don't need any of that. Didn't find the key for that chest down there, though. Very curious. I'm gonna switch. Yeah, he's a great sword because I get bonuses because I'm a Malakath worshiper, right? There's a Daedric thing or something over there? I guess? I don't ever remember there being one, but...
Sure.
No, you didn't. I saw a dragon.
Keep your voice down. I'm fine, but we should go inside to talk.
What's going on? And who's this?
He's a friend. Saved my life, in fact.
Yeah, I saved his life. Don't ask how he got all those cuts. Those were from the dragon, too.
Tell me all. Feindahl thinks he can woo Camilla Valerius away from me. She's already mine, I keep telling him.
You do know that there are more bigger priorities going on right now, right?
You look like a traveler. Someone that has seen faraway places and heard new stories.
Something like that. I could go talk to them and... yeah, we'll do it. We'll do that, and then we'll go back to the museum.
Sigrid, we have company.
Hi.
Papa isn't too friendly with strangers, but you seem all right.
I'm so worried about you. Come, you two must be hungry. Sit down and I'll get you something to eat.
Now then, boy, what's the big mystery? What are you doing here, looking like you lost an argument with a caveman?
I don't know where to stop. You know I was assigned to General Tully as a guard. We were stopped in Helgen when we were attacked by a dragon.
What? A dragon? We were stopped in Helgen.
You aren't drunk, are you, boy?
Well, that is beside the point.
Not much more to tell. This dragon flew over and just wrecked the whole confusion. I don't know if anyone else got out alive.
So he's at least a fifth level wizard if he can cast mass confusion.
Let them know what's happened. I thought you could help us out. Food, supplies, a place to stay.
Of course. Any friend of Hadvar's is a friend of mine.
Oh, we're great friends.
Help however I can. Like I said, I'm glad to help in any way I can. But I need your help. We need your help.
Okay. I'll take your healing potions and your garnet ring. But the rest of this is not super useful to me.
The Jarl needs to know if there's a dragon on the loose. Riverwood is defenseless. We need to get word to Jarl Balgruuf in Whiterun to send whatever soldiers he can. If you'll do that for me, I'll be in your debt.
Someone has to get to the Jarl. Someone has to let him know that Riverwood's in danger. If you do that, I'll be in your debt. Can you put armor on my horse? Yes?
Of course.
Just...
Well, I'd better get back to work. You two make yourselves at home.
Can I help you?
No, you can't help me, but,
It's nice to be back in a friendly spot, huh? Listen.
I can't take soul gem.
Make your own way to Solitude from here. I'd recommend heading to Whiterun, just down the road from here. From there you can take a carriage to Solitude.
Wear your hat, Hadvar. You might be thinking I'm doing that to make sure he doesn't see me steal anything, but in fact, I just wanted to put a basket on his head. I did.
Papa's isn't too friendly with strangers, but you seem all right.
I'm glad you think that.
The blacksmith. I'm his assistant. I mean apprentice.
There you go. It's a gift. It is such a gift.
Make yourself at home. I'm spoken for, you know, so don't get any ideas.
Oh, I know. I wasn't gonna even presume. Soda light. And a kettle.
Alvar and I, we got a daughter, little Dorothy.
Yes, I know, she's right there. You have a very, very weird... So she says. Why do you work down here in the basement?
Listen, you should go to Solitude and join up with the Imperial
Legion. Yeah, I could join the Imperial Legion. No, I already got a job. I work for the museum. Speaking of, it's time to get back to the museum. Which I can just fast travel right to. So I've got some bad news about those vases. Turns out they broke. Along with the rest of Helgen. For the record, not my fault. It was that way when I got there.
Oh, you're here.
Yes, I am. So there is an easy way to, like, just drop everything into a single, like, bucket, and then it'll automatically sort everything out throughout the entire place for you. Iron boots, iron gauntlets, iron plate armor, iron plate boots, iron shield. Don't necessarily know what that is. Longbows don't go in here, but hunting bows do. I don't know why. There's some things that are just kind of like the low-level stuff that's like, yeah, no, we don't actually put that in the museum for some reason, despite the fact that it's a museum of, like, literally everything. So we'll do that. And we'll give it a little bit. You see, it starts populating the things up there. You see, there's gauntlets, boots. Although I'm wondering if the iron plate armor goes someplace else. Because it's technically a Creation Club thing. Please wait for the current operation to complete. And then if you go off to the little sides here, there actually are big worms of just mannequins. It's like mannequins and weapon stands and all this stuff that you just put whatever you want in here. Finished updating, 0 displays. Finished updating, 16 displays. Which I have to ask now. Is it going to mark? Dwarven plate, skull and fur, iron plate. No, it is not currently flagging my iron plate as marked. So, yeah, that's what I thought was going to happen. Considering we have 2 pieces of iron plate here. Those probably go in that DLC Hall of Wonders. Now I have to wait for the other ones and freaking blah blah blah. What is that thing? Shale Gorath shaped amber? It's really kind of fun to look at some of these because, quite honestly, I have not completed all the different DLC that comes with the, It comes with the anniversary edition. I haven't finished it. There. And the iron plate boots. So, to give you an idea. But then I also have all these other ones that I don't know where they go because these are all, like, some of the stuff are things I've done before in earlier versions of this, and the other ones are, a lot of these are brand new for me, at least. Like, we have the Gallery of Natural Science, which I've done before, but also, you know, things have been added to it. Fairies. Didn't have fairies before. There we go. So some of these you can automatically take these. There's the sodalite that we picked up. And then these are all the different animal displays you can do. Elk display. Inventory. I thought I had enough to make that. And you get little plaques on them, too. See, the wolves of Skyrim are a common sight, roaming individually or in small packs. They will hunt other animals, but often divert their attention if a person draws near. Wolves come in standard tundra or arctic wolf variations, the latter of which are more ferocious breed. And you get, like, nice little taxidermy dioramas. It's so cool, right? I love this mod. It's just, everything is just so cool. This is the entomology exhibit. You can actually, you have fertile soil, so you can actually plant different plants in here that can grow and stuff like that. Then I think the other one, that stone one, is the one that I'm kind of curious about. The, where was it? This thing, the Stone of the Forebears. I've never seen this before. I have no idea what it is. And because of that, I have no idea where it goes. So we're going to explore and see if I can find a little nook and cranny somewhere. This is the, I think this is Dwemer? No, this is the Daedric Hall. And then down here is the Hall of Lost Empires. This is where the Dwemer and the Falmer and all that stuff are. And then down here, of course, we have the little sign that says, section of the museum is under construction and close to the Daedric Patients. Because this is actually part of a bigger project that's currently still under development. The development team that's been working on putting this together, they've also been working on something called the Odyssey of the Dragonborn, which is an even bigger version of this that will ultimately, like, allow you to do a whole bunch of other stuff. Oh, wow. Assuming these are drinks of some sort. That's ship in a jar. These are the jars. Oh, whoa. Dragon figurines? Alduin statue? Galaxy sword? Ninjato? Ronin sword? Oh my goodness, what the heck? What's all this? Yeah, I don't have the required item. I'm sure I don't. I didn't know all these were in here. This has to be where the thing is, right? Somewhere in here? 20-string harp guitar, banjo, traditional lute, gold horn, tenor recorder. Instruments, huh? The upright harp. These appear to be different dining things, Leviathan stuff. Oh, wow. A hookah? Okay. These are skulls. Plate. Oh, wait, no, I did get one of these. I got the Morrowind plate. Because those are a thing. But I didn't. Dolls? Blood? Stuff? These are weapons. Glasses, weird collectibles. Meteorite, world stone. Is that? No, I don't have the world stone. Okay. This is. We're gonna have fun trying to hunt down all this stuff. But yeah, I don't. P- Pretty sure it doesn't go in here. Is there any other rooms that are open up besides? No, I don't see them. I mean, it definitely looks like something that's like religion related, and I know the religion display is up here. These. Oh, maybe. Goblet of Infinite Grace. An Ebony Raven. Tempest Dominus. Lantern of the Ancestors. Stone of the Forebears. There it is. I don't know if there's anything else even really. I mean, there's probably the Amulet of Talos, which... Got those. Pelagius' hip bone, which I think I can make a replica of now. So certain things, since you can't, like, because they're cool. Okay, because three bone meal and two clay, which I don't have. But you can, So if, like, certain items you want to keep on hand or you don't want to part with or anything like that, or quest items or something like that, you can easily create replicas to put on display in the museum as long as you have, like... And this is the chest that you just put stuff to, like, automatically get sorted, which is... Adventurer's Journal, Explorer's Guide to Skyrim, I don't really need the notes, Journal, actually I don't think the journal's needed either, so I don't think journals actually sort anywhere. That's a quest item? Why is that a quest item? Yeah, just automatically display those, please. Oh, wait. Gotta go this way to get up to my apartment. Zero new displays. Well, the books do get sorted. Yeah, down here is the storeroom. This is where they have all the wine and everything. That... You have a wine rack. And, like, they'll populate in here. All the different bottles you get and everything. And then you can mix them too. Sorting chest! See, this is where you can just kind of toss everything else. Kettle, antlers, linen wrap. Yeah, even if you do potions or anything like that, it's all... gets sorted away in here. I'm gonna throw one lockpick and... just to see if they get sorted into places that might need them. And then it'll sort it into all the different places, like you can then find them in here, like leathercraft supplies and whatnot. You have a replica workbench. Please check for unsortable items. Those are not unsortable items, friend. See, these are the miscellaneous items. Yeah, there it goes. Yeah, the hammer's now in there. But as you put more and more stuff in these places, it'll start getting filled up more and more. Like, you'll have drinks in here, and cups, and all sorts of different things. Foods populate in here. This is where you put dishes. See, we put a bucket in there, and now there's a bucket in here. Also, we can display a painting. And just as time goes on, we put more and more stuff in here, and it starts getting filled more and more. Oh yeah, this is our personal bedroom. Fireplace, this is where our fate cards go. Clothes, jewelry, so it's like these are the rings we put away. It's kind of crazy. We even get a hot tub. See? And eventually we can build stuff in the side rooms for, like, kids or followers that want to stay here. And this is my favorite room. This is just where all your random armor and everything goes. And then if you really want to get rid of stuff, you can put it in this bucket, which is the sell pile, and then it will automatically sell stuff out of there, and you can get the money over... usually there's, like, a little chest that'll pop up over here that'll have all of the money. Yeah, to give him a little bit more of an idea of what we're doing here. And I think with all of that, I think I've pretty much covered explaining most, if not everything, there is to know about the start of the Legacy of Dragonborn mod. And man, the frame rate is terrible up here. Jump down. I did not mean to do that. Usually I can jump down from there. Oops. Can I jump down from up here? Yes. All right. So with that said, I think I'm going to take a little bit of a break here Come back here in a few minutes. We'll keep going with this, because I'm having a good time. How about you guys? I think it's kind of neat to see all this, like, other stuff that's, like, it's, like, almost a completely different game that you've kind of added on to it. And you could completely just ignore the original game and just go around and try and build up this museum. Like, at this point, they don't even know I'm Dragonborn yet? And it's still, it's great.